Welcome back to the Leaning Eye Channel, guys, the show that teaches you how to eliminate the struggle from your own life. In this video, we're going to go over the next part in the $7 million found in waste series. If you haven't seen the previous parts, you should go back and look at them. They're going to be linked here or here, or something like that. I was supposed to get this back in December to you guys, and I just couldn't figure out how to download the original footage. So I figured that out finally, so here it is.
Here we are, it's day two. This is where the sewing department used to be. It's just a skeleton of what it was. Look at all this waste, all this space to place overproduction. There's still plenty of overproduction. But here's the cool thing. I come in this morning, they're having the factory meeting with all the managers. They've already found a use for the space. They've moved the location. I showed up to the meeting. No one was there. I was like, what's going on? And they'd already, you took the bones, they picked clean, and are repurposing it. Amazing. I'm in this old sewing room here. I found this nice white cabinet with a piece of vinyl, Velcro. Let's check out what's behind it. Oh, look at this, overproduction. Overproduction for parts, it looks like. They try to save them. Upon saving them, they stuffed them into a cabinet. Upon stuffing them into a cabinet and then closing it to keep them from getting dirty, they probably forgot about them. Well, I don't know if you can see this on the camera, but they're all moldy. All moldy. So, that didn't help at all. Another case against overproduction. Here we are, part two, and we've got new tables. They're pushed against the windows. What's going to happen is there's the pods on the other side of this wall here. The moment something's done, the completed cover pops out. I don't know why there's all this overproduction here. Very concerning to me. I was told we have overproduction because they're waiting on the iron. So now they have an iron. We've got a second iron. We have water run, air hoses run, super exciting. This came over here this morning. We'll keep you updated on the progress. All right, we've got our embroidery department over here. It's just recently thrown together. Currently, they're just using what we have, but we're gonna be making some specialized tables that fit the requirements that she asked for. Similar to a restaurant, we've got these two pods operational. We have one waitress essentially feeding the two pods here on this side. There's some transportation batch work going on here. That's all right. Same thing, looks like there's one person that does the separating, and they just feed the pods as they need that.
And I wanted to point out the fact that during this time, even though we had just moved over, other parts of the organization are organically reusing previous parts. This was done without my instruction, without the instruction or hand-holding of anybody else. It's really incredible to see them make use of old things. That's part one. Another important part is to notice that there's gonna be a portion in there about overproduction. During that time, they ended up trying to save stuff extra that they stored. It became moldy, and then they had to throw them all away. They were no good. There was all that vinyl and time, and then all that space it took up for years, and then they had to get rid of it anyways. So keep that in mind when you're thinking about overproduction. It's not just that you made more parts than you need. Think about all the other parts that are associated when you have too much inventory. I hope to finish this series soon, but if you guys like this kind of content, this kind of educational thing, I'd love for you to leave comments down below if you want to learn more about being efficient. If you're interested in learning more, go ahead and like, subscribe, and please sign up. This is a great example of how all the stuff I'm doing at home directly applies to work. And if you really want to help, share this with a friend, someone that you might think would be interested in this. All right, with that, we'll see you later, guys.